To the death site, they're going in for some initial attacks. There's a lot of attacks going on there.
I still see your shadows in my room. Can't take back the love that I gave you. It's to the point where I love and I hate you, and I cannot change you, so I must replace you.
Hello, my name is Shadow, and welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm going to be opening and reviewing this new Alter Chronos that I've just got. Now, this Alter Chronos is the balance type. It's from Takeru Tomy. A cool feature about it is its layer can change two modes. It has, like, a stamina mode and an attack mode. Basically, it has something that changes the center of balance that changes what mode it is in. And the pieces that are used for Alter Chronos is obviously the Alter Chronos layer. The disc is 6. The frame is Meteor. And the driver is Trans. So let's get right into opening it. After the long process of putting the stickers on, here is the out-of-the-box Alter Chronos. Now, this is a God layer system Beyblade, so it's obviously going to have a really nice design, and it does have a really nice design. So let's get Alter Chronos in some battles and see what he can do.
For the first battle, I'm going to be using Alter Chronos versus Killer Deathscyther.
Now, for the battles with Alter Chronos, I'm going to be doing 1-3 with each mode. So right now, it is in, like, the stamina mode, and after the 1-3, I'm going to put it in attack mode.
3, 2, 1.
Now, Killer Deathscyther is already going in from hard attacks, but Alter Chronos is remaining in the middle. It is getting knocked around a bit with the stamina mode on right now. It has a lot more stamina than Killer Deathscyther. He's an attack type, so that's going to be an easy win for Alter Chronos with the score of 1-0.
2.
3-2-1. Let's rip. Rip. Big initial first contact. Killer Deathscyther is remaining, trying to stay in the middle, but that's going to be a first finish for Alter Chronos, and that's going to be a win 3-0. Alter Chronos was trying to stay in the middle, but Killer Deathscyther just kept pushing in, and that ended up being its doom. Too many attacks, and it was a burst finish. 3-0, Alter Chronos. Now I'm going to be changing modes. Alter Chronos is still going to be going against Killer Deathscyther, but this time Alter Chronos is going to be in its attack mode. So it's going to be attack versus attack, and we'll see what happens. On to the first round. 3, 2, 1, let's rip. Rip. Now, Killer Deathscyther is just running around the stadium, going to the middle, and they're circling around each other. Some hard hits there. Alter Chronos does look like it has more stamina than Killer Deathscyther. Yes, that's going to be a survivor finish with a score of 1-0. Alter Chronos.
2.
3, 2, 1, let's rip. Rip. Killer Deathscyther going in for some initial attacks. There's a lot of attacks going on there, but it does look like... Oh, that's a double burst! I have absolutely no clue who just won that. They're just going back and forth attacking. It's a double burst. I'm going to go back and check the replay to see who won that. After looking back at the replay, it was a double burst, so there are going to be no points awarded after that. And now I'm going to resume with the score still 1-0, Alter Chronos. On to round 3. 3, 2, 1, rip. Rip. Just circling around the stadium, Alter Chronos does go for the middle right away. Does have more stamina than Killer Deathscyther, so that may be a win for Alter Chronos already, just seeing how much stamina. And yes, that's going to be a survivor finish to Alter Chronos. Score of 2-0. On to round 4. 3, 2, 1, rip. Rip. Alter Chronos does look like it goes for the middle right away every time, even on attack mode, which is a little weird. It does look like Alter Chronos does have another ring out survivor finish, my bad. And that's going to be a win to Alter Chronos against Killer Deathscyther. Both times, it was a quick 3-0 win for Alter Chronos. Killer Deathscyther just couldn't take the power of this new Alter Chronos. For the next battle, it is going to be Alter Chronos
versus Hell Salamander. And let's see what happens.
One, 3, 2, 1, let's rip.
The Hell Salamander is bouncing already off the middle. It is wobbling a little bit, so that does look like it's going to be a quick survivor finish win to Ultra Chronos. And yes, with Ultra Chronos' really good stamina on its stamina mode, it can pull off a survivor finish most times. And as we saw on the attack mode as well, it could do some pretty good survivor finishes. So I would say Ultra Chronos, in general, would lean towards the more stamina side. Moving on to round two. 3, 2, 1, let's rip. Rip. That was a kind of a bad launch on Hell Salamander. Ultra Chronos is staying in the middle with Hell Salamander challenging it all the way through, but that does look like another one for Ultra Chronos. But Hell Salamander is keeping its stamina. It looks pretty close, but that is going to be... I'm actually not sure. That looks like a win to Ultra Chronos, but at the same time, it might have been a tie. Again, I'm going to have to go look at the replay and see whose win that was. So after looking back at that, it did look like they both stopped spinning at the same time. It would have been a win for Ultra Chronos, but it had one more attack that took out all of its stamina. At the same time, Hell Salamander lost all of its stamina from the attack. So that's going to be a tie. So we're going to continue with the score of 1-0, Ultra Chronos. On to round 3. 3, 2, 1, let's rip. Rip. They're both challenging the middle again. Looks pretty close, but Hell Salamander does have better control in the middle, but Hell Salamander does not have enough stamina to control the winner, and that's going to be the middle, my bad. And that's going to be a win for Ultra Chronos. And it is now a score of 2-0. Real quick, I forgot to mention that for this battle and the next battle, I am not going to be using Ultra Chronos' attack mode because they do seem kind of similar. And when I went through to try to do some attack modes with Killer Death Scyther, they both just kept flying out of the stadium and it's hard to get anywhere with that. So I'm just going to stick with the stamina mode for Ultra Chronos for the next two battles, this one and its next opponent. Going on to round 4. 3, 2, 1, let's rip. Let's rip. And it does look like another battle for the middle. House Salamander, again, does not have a lot of stamina, and Ultra Chronos is keeping its stamina pretty good, and that's going to be a win for Ultra Chronos. 3-0 win again. Ultra Chronos is destroying all of its opponents. So that is going to be 3-0 Ultra Chronos' win. For the next and final battle, Ultra Chronos is going to be going against this Orb Aegis Outer Octa combo. I will leave a link to that combo video in the description below if you guys want to check that out and see how I made this combo. So let's get right into the battle. On to round 1. 3, 2, 1. Now, it is going to be a battle for the middle since they are both really stamina types, although Ultra Chronos is a balance type. It does look like they have an equal amount of stamina right now, but we'll see how that continues as looks like they're both wobbling, but that's going to be a survivor finish for Orb Aegis with a score of 1-0. That was pretty close, but Ultra Chronos did not have enough stamina. As you can see, that's the most it's clicked so far. It was like 2 clicks away from bursting, so that was pretty close on Orb Aegis's part. And Orb Aegis only clicked twice. So these are going to be some pretty close battles. Moving on to round 2. 3, 2, 1, let's rip. Alright. That was a huge initial impact, but that's going to be a ring out finish. The score of 1-1. That was a really good attack block for Ultra Chronos. Although Orb Aegis did launch second, so Ultra Chronos did have the advantage there, but that is going to be scored 1-1. Moving on to round 3. 3, 2, 1, let's rip. Let's rip. That was a huge scrape from the first start, and that is going to be a big initial impact that's going to get Orb Aegis the middle, but they're both wobbling currently, and that's going to be a survivor finish for Orb Aegis, the Octa gimmick. saved it from the survivor finish for Ultra Cronus's favor. The, like, Life After Death 2.0 from this gimmick definitely saved it. So, it is going to be a score of 2-1. Moving on to round 4. 3-2-1. Let her rip. Let her rip. Big impact, and they're both going to be battling for the middle. Back and forth, and that's going to be a first finish. There's a lot of attacks there. And Orby just managed to block all of them. That's going to be a burst. And that's going to be also a score of 4-1 win for Orb Aegis. So Orb Aegis was the only Beyblade to beat Alter Kronos. Thank you guys so much for watching the video, and I will see you next time.